Well, hello everyone. This is Daniel Colgrove. I'm Technology Director with Broadleaf Commerce. Today I'm joined by Albert Bautista. He is a senior architect with Broadleaf, and he's the team lead of our B2B features we'll be showcasing today.
Thanks, Daniel. Glad to be here.
So let's go ahead and get started. So when you look at the B2B market, it's historically really been more seller-driven, and there's been a decreased emphasis in the customer experience. And this is starting to change, and really the market is trying to transition and provide experiences on the B2B platform that mimic those of the B2C, customer experience focus. So first, we're finding that customers tend to purchase larger quantities and subsequently spend more money in the B2B space. And which really, it's not uncommon to see that. And there's many industries where customers would purchase complete pallets of products. Second, we're seeing that the average conversion rate for B2B purchases is well above that of B2C. On average, the B2B conversion is about 7% versus a 3% conversion rate for B2B sites. Third, the B2B online retailers that have multiple channels actually are seeing a lot of brand loyalty with customers. And the premise here is that the customer gets the convenience of shopping online, but they also may get the convenience of mobile shopping, and then can still have the opportunity to pick up the phone and do it a traditional sales rep call if needed. And then last, B2B retailers are seeing some benefits of reducing their cost by trying to move much of the transactions off of the offline phone call to an online experience where their systems can handle most of the transaction. We also see companies coming in and providing complete marketplace solutions. And then we also have companies setting up and establishing purchasing networks that are kind of driven to volume, trying to increase the volume of those sales. Broadleaf can actually play within each one of those particular models as well. So in addition, B2B solutions oftentimes have special requirements that are different than B2B solutions. For example, for B2B purchases, oftentimes you might see purchase orders as well as special contracting prices. And you also see a lot of vendors that come in and they play together within the one site. So kind of cross-vendor fulfillment might be another scenario that happens. And so Broadleaf does support the multi-channel concept as well. In particular, we do have an order management system module that allows any inbound phone sales to be initiated by the salesperson, but that order can actually be funneled through Broadleaf and then later provide an access point for the customer to see that order online. Broadleaf, at its very core, is a framework, and it is designed to be extended and customized. So for clients that have unique needs, the platform actually can be customized to fit those needs. So with that background, I'd like to transition the presentation over to Albert.
Thanks, Daniel. Hello, everyone. As Daniel mentioned, my name is Albert Bautista, and I'm a senior architect here at Broadleaf. Today, we'll be talking about Broadleaf's powerful B2B platform. We'll be going over many of the out-of-box features, as well as discuss how our solution can handle several B2B business models. And as Daniel mentioned, B2B process flows can be complex and can vary drastically depending on industry. So let's begin by talking about three common B2B models and how different features in Broadleaf can support each one of them. It's not uncommon for a business to have a unique process that will utilize and combine several, if not all, of these concepts. To begin, our primary B2B capabilities support a direct sales model seamlessly. For example, a manufacturer or retailer may wish to sell directly to other businesses. This model can present many complexities, which include unique contracts and pricing for each business, hierarchical permissions and authorities for different departments within each organization, and finally, they may need an order approval process at time of checkout. We've built several B2B features that can help with each of these requirements. Next, we'll talk about external procurement systems integration. Let's say that you're a seller working with a large organization that integrates with an enterprise procurement system like Ariba or SideQuest. Your online store that runs on Broadleaf needs to have punch-out capabilities in order to communicate with these back-end systems. We've made this easy by integrating with a punch-out-to-go gateway. Finally, in the last model we'll be covering, we'll talk about our marketplace or reseller partner platform. For this scenario, let's say your organization needs a platform to onboard multiple third-party resellers and partners into a system that allows them to manage their own unique catalog and prices. This scenario and more can be handled with our multi-tenant platform. We'll be going into more details on how this is done in the following slides. So these are the three business models that we'll be focusing on today, and let's begin by talking about the direct sales model first. The most straightforward and prevalent model is direct B2B sales, where enterprises wish to sell directly to other enterprises. In the following demo, we'll show some common B2B features that have been enabled on our B2C eClinic web store. We'll demonstrate onboarding new accounts into the platform, setting up members and roles, showing contract pricing, and finally illustrating a few common B2B-centric features like quick order and easy reordering. Okay, to set some context for this demo, let's imagine that an account rep in your company has just negotiated a new contract with a buyer organization and a new account needs to be onboarded into the system. Let's go ahead and navigate to our admin to see what that looks like. We'll go ahead and log in and go ahead and browse to the account section. Here, you'll see a list of all accounts currently configured in the system. Let's go ahead and add a new organization. We'll click Add Account and we'll create a new organization. Let's call this a sample organization. And let's fill in the account number here. And I'll choose Master Account and click Save. Great. This is all we really need to do to create a basic organizational account. Next, let's go ahead and onboard some customers and members into this account as well. If your organization already has a large CRM solution in place, our platform has the ability through exposed services to support custom member imports as well. Or if a self-registration is enabled, users can register into a specific account themselves and wait for approval from the admin of that account. For the purposes of this demo, let's assume that the customer has already self-registered and is awaiting approval into this account. Let's assume that I received an email saying that John Smith is awaiting approval. Go ahead and click Add Member and search for John Smith. Select John Smith and say that he is not deactivated and click Save. We should also assign this customer a specific role in this organization. So let's go ahead and select John Smith again and add, let's say that this user is a buyer in this organization. So we'll go ahead and add the role account buyer and click Save. And I'll save this account. Perfect. Now we have an account set up with a member and are ready to browse our B2B site. So let's go ahead and navigate to our B2B branded test store and see what that looks like. We'll go ahead and log in as John Smith, the account member that we just onboarded. Notice in the header here, you'll see the name of the account this member is associated with, along with other B2B centric capabilities. In a lot of B2B scenarios, buyers for an account usually need to order many things in bulk. For example, if your organization has a large product catalog with part or item numbers, it's useful for customers to quickly add items to their order without having to browse through the entire site to find a specific item. To meet this use case, we provide a quick order feature, easily enter a configurable item code or number and quantity very quickly. So let's say I have a catalog of item codes in front of me and I'm ready to add these items to my cart. I'm going to go ahead and type in DD and choose the second one here. Notice that that feature provided an auto-suggest feature to help the user. I'll enter a quantity, I'll say 10 here. We also provide this lookup context to help the user as they're entering their order information. So I'm going to go ahead and enter a few items here that are on my list. And then tap to the next item. Click one. When I type in an item that does not exist, there's some helpful context here saying that this item is not found. I'll go ahead and enter some more items here as well. And I'll add one more. This time, let's go ahead and try adding by UPC code. Great. Now that I've finished with my order, I can click on Add All Items to Cart. And now this bulk order is ready to be checked out. Another common B2B feature centers around custom contract pricing. Let's go ahead and go back to the home page really quick. Suppose that some organizations have negotiated special pricing for certain items in the catalog. To illustrate this, let's log into a different account that has special negotiated contract pricing associated with it. Before we do that, you should go ahead and take notice that Green Ghost here has a sale price of $9.99 for John Smith, who is part of the sample organization. Let's go ahead and log out And let's go ahead and log in as Bill. Notice that Bill is part of the XYZ Corporation. And if we scroll down, Green Ghost now has a sale price of $9.29 instead of $9.99. In addition to this, accounts have the ability to set tiered pricing rules as well. So for example, if you purchase five or more of these items, you'll receive them at a discounted price of $8.29 each instead of the individual $9.29 price. So as you can see, it's pretty simple to onboard new accounts as well as enable B2B centric features like contract-based pricing, tiered pricing, and quick order functionality. Now let's go ahead and add a little bit more complexity around our organizational model. Oftentimes, when you're dealing with corporate accounts, members that are buying items on behalf of a group must have the order go through an approval process before being finalized. In this next demo, I'd like to show you how setting up members with different roles, like approver and buyer, allows me to set up a purchase approval workflow with configurable order thresholds. To set up this example, let's go back to our admin console and look at the details for one of our hierarchical accounts. So let me go back to the accounts list here and choose XYZ Accounting Department. We'll go ahead and click on the account members tab and see that we have two members in this group. We have Kevin and Angela. In this demo, Kevin is a buyer and Angela is an approver. We've also set up an order approval rule. So if we click on this tab, you can see that this rule says that orders greater than $50 must go into an order approval process. This screen also allows you to specify other rules that target item, time, and request-based conditions. So let's go ahead and switch back over to our customer-facing B2B site and test this scenario. First, I'll go ahead and log in as Kevin, who is the buyer of that XYZ accounting department. Let's go ahead and log in as Kevin. And let's go ahead and add Green Ghost to his cart. For this part of the demo, I'm going to keep the quantity as 1 and proceed to checkout. We'll go ahead and enter some default shipping information here. And we'll select charge this to the accounting department option as our payment method. And we'll complete the order. Great. Notice that my order has submitted with no issues. Remember that we set the order approval limit here at $50. So if we go to our order history page, you can see that the status of this order is submitted, which is what we expect. So let's go ahead and create another order here for over $50 and see what happens. We'll go back to the home page and add Green Ghost to our cart. This time, let's go and increase the quantity here to 7 so that our total is over $50. Let's go ahead and proceed to checkout once again and perform the same steps here as last time. I'll enter some default billing information and choose charge to department account as my payment method and complete the order. Notice now on the confirmation page, we get a message saying that this order is now awaiting approval. So let's go ahead and log in as Angela, who's the approver for this account, to review this order. I'm going to go ahead and log out and log in as Angela. Notice that Angela sees a pending order notification here indicating that there are items for her to review. I'm going to go ahead and go to the pending approvals page. And here we can see the list of all orders that need to be approved or rejected for this account. So we'll go ahead and you can even see the order details of that order as well. And for this demo, let's go ahead and just approve this order. So we'll go click approve and say approve selected. Perfect. Now the last step in this demo is to confirm that Kevin's order has actually been submitted. So I'll go ahead and log out once more and log in as Kevin. And if we go to his order history page, you'll see that his order is in the submitted status, indicating that the order has been successfully approved. Since we're on this page, I'd also like to point out one other B2B-centric feature provided out of box, which you can see here. Many times, business customers place repeat orders, so we provided a way to easily reorder all or some of the same items that you may have purchased in the past. Let's say Kevin comes back every month to reorder the same items again and again. In this scenario, he can go to his order history page, easily view all of his previous orders, and quickly place a repeat order if needed. That concludes our demo of the B2B features associated with a direct sales model. Now, let's move on to the next business model and talk about implementations that require punch-out capabilities from external procurement systems. Punch-Out2Go is a punch-out enablement gateway that allows for cross-integration and routing between any procurement platform like Ariba, FlyQuest, and IBM to your B2B or B2C enabled e-commerce store. From your procurement engine, you can punch out to your site, shop, add things to your cart, and when ready, have the ability to transfer that order back into your procurement engine where you can finalize your order for fulfillment. For this demonstration, we'll be using Punch-Out2Go's test sandbox that mimics the integration flow for many of the procurement systems you see here. Let's see what that looks like. We'll go ahead and log in to Punch-Out2Go's test sandbox environment. Go ahead and log in and go to develop Punch-Out. Notice that they provide us with a mechanism to punch out. I'll go ahead and click the Punch Out Now button to initiate a punch out session. Notice that the gateway has redirected us to our Broadleaf store where we're logged in as a procurement system user. And in this case, it's Daniel. We'll go ahead and add an item to our cart. We'll go ahead and add Hop and Hot Sauce. Now, if we view our cart, since we have a punch out session enabled, Broadleaf provides a transfer order option that enables us to send these details back to Procurement Gateway. So we'll go ahead and click Transfer Order. Perfect. Now you can see that the order details have been transferred back to the procurement system for any workflow or approval steps. Notice that we have line item details here for the products that we've added to our order. So as you can see, our Punch-Out2Go module enables seamless punch-out capabilities on our Broadleaf site. So whether you're maintaining business processes within Broadleaf, as in the direct sales model, or integrating with an existing procurement system as shown here, our platform provides various mechanisms to fulfill your unique B2B requirements. Finally, let's discuss our third B2B business model, the multi-tenant marketplace. Our multi-everything capabilities support a wide variety of B2B use cases, such as marketplaces, value-added resellers, and franchise business models, to name a few. For this final demo, we'll focus on one particularly interesting use case that shows how a wholesaler can create a marketplace platform for resellers with independent storefronts. To illustrate this, let's imagine that we have a company called the Heat Clinic Corporation, who is a global wholesaler of hot sauces. Now, they see a great business opportunity in launching a new platform that enables them to partner with local and regional hot sauce resellers. The primary goal of this initiative is to help sell us exclusive products through this already mature reseller network, as well as give smaller independent resellers that may or may not have the necessary infrastructure in place the means to sell their own products as well. To demonstrate this, let's say that the great partner team over at the Heat Clinic Corporation has already made hundreds of reseller relationships, and they are all ready to join this platform. Let's see what it looks like to onboard these new clients into the Broadleaf's marketplace platform. So let's go ahead and go to the admin and log in, refresh really quick, and log into the admin. And when you use Broadleaf's multi-tenant capabilities, you have access to something called the Global Site Admin. Here, you'll have the ability to manage and onboard new vendors and resellers. Let's see what it looks like to set up a new reseller store. So if you go to Site Management and go to Sites, we can go ahead and create a new site. Let's go add a new site. And let's name the site Reseller One. You can also choose how you want to provision the site. We'll say, in this case, we want this to be a subdomain of our main site. So we'll just choose domain prefix and say that the subdomain is Reseller One. And I'll go ahead and save this. In addition to this, Broadleaf has some really powerful features that allow you to control and configure how different catalogs and content propagate into each new site that you provision. We won't get into all those details today, but look out for a more in-depth view of these features in a future webinar. Today, we'll just be using the master catalog and master content data that we want to provision to our reseller sites. In our example scenario, we do this to make sure that each reseller gets a copy of our exclusive product catalog so that they have the ability to sell those items on their site as well. So we'll go ahead and select master profile as the base. And for the assigned catalogs, I'll choose the master catalog. Click add. And I'll click save. Great. We have just now provisioned a new site for reseller one preceded with our exclusive catalog data. Now let's switch roles really quick and see what this looks like from the viewpoint of the reseller. If you click here on change site and look for the reseller one site we just provisioned and select him, this gives us a view of the admin console for the reseller. So to demonstrate modifying the catalog for this reseller, let's go ahead and browse to the catalog section and view the categories. Let's go ahead and add a new reseller one only category. So if we click on merchandise, let's add a new subcategory here under merchandise. And we'll name this new category reseller one exclusives. And click save. We can even preview what that might look like on their main site as well by clicking on this preview on site button. This is a preview of Reseller One's provision site, and notice that if you hover over the merchandise category, you'll see that the Reseller One exclusive category is there. So for the last part of this demo, I'm going to go ahead and close this preview window. And let's navigate back to the global site admin. And let's go ahead and onboard a second reseller into the platform. We'll go to the site management and click sites. We'll follow the same steps as last time and click add site. This time we'll say this new site is reseller 2. This will also be a subdomain as well. So we'll say reseller 2. And as before, we'll use the same base master catalog as last time, as well as the base master profile as well. Click master profile. And for the assigned catalogs, I'll pick the master catalog. And click save. Great. The idea here is to show that the changes made in reseller one's catalog don't get reflected in any new site that we provision. So let's go ahead and switch to Reseller 2's admin site. And navigate to the category section. If we click on the merchandise category, notice that there is no exclusive categories for this reseller. And if we preview Reseller 2's site, the merchandise category does not include Reseller One's catalog data. So Broadleaf's multi-tenant platform allows for the wholesaler to easily make updates to its master catalog and automatically push those changes to each reseller's site. The functionality shown here is just a glimpse of some of the many capabilities you can achieve with Broadleaf's multi-tenant marketplace platform. So as you can see, Broadleaf provides a solid platform of B2B features and capabilities that support a vast array of different business models. We talked about onboarding new accounts into the system, order approval workflows, contract-based pricing, and demonstrated some B2B specific features that support a direct enterprise-to-enterprise sales model. We also talked about external procurement systems integration via the Punchout2Go gateway. And finally, we touched on a complex reseller and partner business model using our multi-tenant marketplace capabilities. Now, we've only scratched the surface of what you can accomplish with these features. So if you have more questions or would like a more in-depth demo to see how your business process fits in, feel free to contact us for more information.